kind of experiments has been done with large particles. You know, usually quantum phenomena are in the minds of many people limited to small scales. A big research program is go to large and large objects. For example, with such big molecules, fullerenes, we also show the fringes showing on the left-hand side. This thing was done by Julian Voss-André, who was a student of mine, who is now an artist in Portland, Oregon. Now, about an important concept, namely randomness in quantum mechanics. Here is a simple example. Suppose you have a source which sends out individual particles of light, one at a time. And it meets a so-called half-silvered mirror, a mirror which reflects half of the intensity and lets half go through. The question is, what does an individual particle do which is not divisible? The point is that it's completely random what this does. It goes either to the right-hand side or it goes down, but this is absolutely random. And today in physics, we say that there is no cause. This is, to me, is one of the most important discoveries of science in the 20th century, that there are events for which there is no causal explanation possible. They are objectively random. To put it in a provocant way, I sometimes say, not even God knows what will come out.